This is Learning Logistics with Factorio, Season 3, Episode 1. My name is Martin Wölker. I'm the true logistician. My first buffer tutorial I did with this factory. Below is my central warehouse. On the top left are the research facilities. I've linked all the videos below. The factory is on the right. All buffers are filled. You can see this by the green lights. In the new season, I want to care about producing electronic components. This is a part of the old factory to produce electronic components. I remove all materials out of the boxes and so the production starts. Then I put a little bit pressure on the production and say, hey, produce also some parts for the rockets and some productivity modules. The machines start working and we will see what will happen next. Lights change their color and yellow means there's a request for material, and the yellow light you see is a request for copper. Pink indicates this is below the upper limit, just the red circuits now. Now there are two requests for copper and cable. There's enough copper, but the consumption of copper continues. The buffer sinks below the upper limit and becomes pink. There's no request for copper and the feeding of copper stops. But there's still a request for cable, and now the feeding with cable starts. Let's make a jump to the next event. The cable buffer is filled now and there are no other requests for material. Red circuits are used more and more, and now it's below the lower limit. It becomes red and the production of red circuits starts. There were enough cables in the chest and we stopped the delivery of cable from the central warehouse. I use an empty conveyor as a signal to order material I need. In this case, I need some copper plates and plastic bars. The capacity is a resource and it has to be managed. So, free capacity means, is there some space in buffers so I can use the time to fill them. And now there is a lack of blue circuits and the production starts. The buffers for copper plates and plastic bars are full, but they are still in use, so they become pink. This is the indicator for the green circuits. There's a lag and the production starts. The production is still working and the material is in use, so the buffers sink below the upper limit, and step by step more and more signals become pink. I indicated the red circle. This is the last order. It stops and so there are no requests for the central warehouse. All buffers switch to yellow and send a request for material. My central warehouse sends now 5 different materials. I stopped the production of combinators, red and green cable, also the productivity modules and the parts of the rocket. And now the system still continues to work, and step by step all the buffers are filled in the same order as they are used. First the high level products, then the lower level products, and at the end the basic products. So you see, this is a self-organizing system. Every consumption of material triggers the production of the right material, or if it was produced here, the supply from my central warehouse. This was a brief summary and demonstration about the pull logic with buffers. In the next parts of my third season about pull logic with Factorio, I will build a new factory for electronic components. So don't forget to subscribe my channel, and if you have questions or need some support with Factorio or in logistics, don't hesitate to contact me. Bye.